So we have covered all the theoretical portion of financial accounting. Now we'll move on to cost accounting. So what do you mean by cost accounting? It is the application of accounting and costing principles, methods and techniques in the ascertainment of cost and the analysis of saving or excess cost incurred as compared with previous experience or with the standards. So here we will apply the accounting and costing principles, methods and techniques. For what? In order to ascertain the cost. Then we will analyze the savings or the excess cost incurred when compared with the previous year's experience. Right. So that is what is meant by cost accounting. Now we'll see the main concepts of cost accounting. There are so many terms coming to the concepts of cost accounting. We'll deal with one by one. Okay. First one is cost. So there is a cost involved to purchase or to produce anything. This cost may be different for the same product. That depends upon the stages of completion. That is, the cost changes according to the stage of a product is in. For example, raw material, work in progress, finished goods, etc. So the cost of a product cannot be perfect and it may vary for the same product depending upon the different constraints and the situations of the production and market. Next is expenses. Some costs, they are actual, such as raw material cost, freight cost, labor cost, etc. But some expenses, they are attributable to cost. That is, to earn revenue, some expenses are incurred like rent, salary, insurance, etc. Some expenses are variable, some are semi-variable and some of fixed nature. Next concept is loss. In the case of expenses, they are incurred in order to obtain something, right? But the losses, they are incurred without any compensation, but they add to the cost of the product or service without any value addition to it. Now comes to cost center, another concept of cost accounting, cost center. Cost center refers to a particular area of activity. So there may be multiple cost centers in an organization. So every cost center will add some cost to the product. And this every cost center, they are responsible for all its activity and cost. A cost center, we can also call it as a department or a sub-department. There are three types of cost centers. First one is personal and impersonal cost centers. A group of persons in an organization, they are responsible as a whole for a group of activity. So then it is called a personal cost center. In case of impersonal cost center, the activities are done with the help of plant and machinery, not with persons. Understood? Operation and process cost center. In an operation department, the same kind of activity is done. In a process cost center, as the name suggests, we can know different kinds of processes are involved. Okay. Then next is product and service cost center. A department where all activities refer to a product, then it is called a product department. So when the centers render their services to a product department, that is for its smooth functioning, they are called service cost centers. Next is profit center. Profit centers are inclusive of cost centers as well as revenue activities. So this profit center, they will set target for the cost centers and they will also delegate the responsibilities to the cost centers. So they adopt policies in order to achieve these targets. Okay, so they play an important role in an organization. Now comes cost drivers. Cost of any product depends upon cost drivers. There may be different types of cost drivers such as number of units or type of products required to produce, etc. So if there is any change in cost driver, the cost of the product changes automatically. Conversion cost. This is the cost required to convert the raw material into product. So what all cost it will include? That is labor, direct expenses, overheads, etc. Carrying cost. It represents the cost to maintain the inventory, that is the lockup cost of inventory, rent of the store, store operation expenses, etc. Out of stock cost. Sometimes loss is incurred due to shortage of stock, such as loss in sale, loss of goodwill of a business or idle machine, etc. Then it is called out of stock cost.